I was just looking through my election deliverables, and they seem a little extreme because they would improve our society so much. They would make everything so much easier for everyone. So it's like, if he could get these things done, then it could really make our society awesome. And if there's anything I know in my entire life is I can make this online university happen. You give me some money, I promise I can make it happen. I mean, we will set the regulations for how, for like what it takes to prove that you pass this course. And I'm someone that knows about it because I remember trying, my dad working for to verify students' identities like way back in the day through so many different techniques. And so I've been thinking about that sort of thing for a long time. And so I also know how to make online courses, and I think a lot of people could learn how to make online courses that don't know how to make them right now. English majors could become instructional designers. And so I'm talking about putting a lot of people to work where they're working with professors that already teach courses to make those courses better, to make those courses have more visuals. Because think about it, the great thing about online courses is that I can put something on the screen. I can keep your attention by making you laugh or making you see something that is just, that catches your attention. A professor, when they're in class, can't do that. They're just talking. But they keep your attention because they can engage with you, they can talk with you. But if we're doing lectures, we can do non-conventional university lectures, and we can make this online university awesome. And so I know all the Democrats, or I know all the Republicans, hate the idea of Bernie Sanders being elected because he wants to give everyone free college. Bernie Sanders is nuts. How could he do that? Well, guess what? I'm the technical Bernie Sanders. I'm the guy that doesn't waste a bunch of money, but hires technical people to do what Bernie Sanders wants to do. I will make a free college for you. I'll make this tax software that it just takes care of your taxes for you, because you already are registered with the website, and your W-2 goes directly to the server, and you'll get an email and say, hey, verify that this information is correct. You'll verify it and you're done. That's it. I'll do that. I mean, I will oversee this AI lawyer because I can figure out how to code it. I'm telling you, I'm the type of person that will figure out how to code it. How would I do it? Well, I can't make speech go to text. So what I'd prefer to do is just ask you questions, and then have you respond. And then I would, because like I could ask you questions on the computer, like you're chatting with me, and then have different paths. And I'm just saying, like, that's the sort of thing that's possible. But the last thing I was going to talk about is AI for the power grid, because I talk about there's like the software suite, which includes a calendar and like an add-on for Chrome. Like if you're traveling, it would automatically alert Chrome or something, or alert your calendar, which would let the energy company know that you're not going to need as much electricity because you're going to be gone or something like that. I'm talking about like making super smart houses that monitor the people inside. So it's like a security system that also monitors your behaviors, so it allows the AI to predict how much electricity needs to go to your part of the grid. I'm the type of person that knows all about power grid stuff because I did a lot of research into power grid security. So like when you elect me, you're not just electing someone that is gonna do normal stuff. I'm the type of person that will take a tiny bit of money and do more than the entire government's freaking, more than, like, if you take half the government's budget, they're not gonna do as much as me with like a tiny bit of money, because I'll use it productively. I'll create an online university that's like cheaper than the budget of Harvard for 10 years. But this online university is gonna be able to serve everyone. The reason I say that is because it's gonna take a lot of server space. That online university is gonna take a lot of effort, especially if it's a dynamic website. But, all right, so you should vote for me. Like, I don't know how you guys can vote for me, but like, you should figure out how to get your friends to vote for me, because I'm planning on putting 20% of the federal workforce out of work. I'm planning on like getting a computer to replace them with this P program I'm talking about, this personal information program that allows you to transfer data and like gets rid of so much paperwork and like, and it makes like a lot of people that have unnecessary jobs unnecessary, and then I'm gonna move them to new jobs. And that's why this green cryptocurrency I'm talking about is so important, because it allows us to have universal basic incomes for people that are out of work. But I'm not planning on leaving these people out of work. I'm planning on having them working doing research or something like that. But that's why we're gonna have to have scientists come and like get together with us and say, hey, this is what we need you to have people do for us. I recently contacted a guy that is in the virus business, and I was like, well, what's keeping you from getting more antibody therapy? I was like, do you need more mice to kill? Like, is that the problem? Because I guess he's getting these cells from mice. And I guess what he said is, or he posted something on the internet the next day, and it said, the reason it's so expensive is because the treatments are like one-time treatments. So like if you're buying Tylenol at the store, yeah, it's like $10 or $5 because you take it all the time. But for antibody therapy, you're only taking it like once in your entire life. So they have to charge a lot to cover their research and development costs. It's not about the mice apparently. But so I'm always trying to figure out like, what do we have to do? What can we do from a logistics perspective to get things taken care of? And I think that's probably the biggest reason you should vote for me.